Hi gang, you've probably all seen the trick where you rub a rubber balloon against your hair and then you put the balloon on a wall. The balloon then sticks to the wall. The balloon gets charged by an effect called the triboelectric effect. Not all materials will work, and which two materials you use together is important too. The list of what materials work is called the triboelectric series. Here's a short list with some materials. The order of the materials in the series is very important. Some are on the positive side of the list, and some are on the negative side. Also, the farther apart the two materials are in the series, the better it works. So rubber, like our rubber balloon, is far apart from hair, so they work well together. But amber and wool are very close together, and won't work as well. Here's a piece of vinyl which I cut from some old window blinds. And here's a glass. You can see that the vinyl and glass are far apart in the triboelectric series, so they should work well together. Just make sure you clean the glass first. We want glass, not grease or dish soap. To see if it worked, I'm using a homemade electroscope. If the two aluminum foil leaves in the jar spread apart, then it worked. And sure enough, the leaves spread apart. It worked. So how does it work? Let's use our vinyl and glass example. We'll go right down to the individual molecule level. A molecule is simply a collection of atoms bonded together. Vinyl is made up of hydrogen and carbon atoms, and glass is made up of oxygen and silicon atoms, though it's not too important to know which atoms are involved. If we add up all the parts of the atoms, vinyl is made up of 15 positive protons and 15 negative electrons. Glass is made up of 66 positive protons and 66 negative electrons. If there are the same number of protons and electrons in a molecule, then the molecule is neutral. It's neither positively charged nor negatively charged. Now what happens if we bring the two molecules together, like we were doing when we rubbed them against each other? When they get close enough, they form an electrochemical bond. It's as if we formed a new, bigger molecule. But most importantly, when the bond is formed, electrons move from the glass molecule to the vinyl molecule. In this case, three electrons are changing places. As a result, the vinyl now has 18 negative electrons, since that's where the three electrons went. And the glass now has 63 electrons, since that's where the electrons came from. Since the vinyl now has more negatively charged electrons than it has positively charged protons, the vinyl is negatively charged. And since the glass now has more positively charged protons than it has negatively charged electrons, the glass is positively charged. And if we then move the molecules apart again, the electrons don't go back to where they were. The vinyl stays negatively charged, and the glass stays positively charged. And that's what happened when I rubbed them together. The molecules are repeatedly forming bonds, then moving apart. Forming bonds, then moving apart. The more I do this, the more electrons move from the glass to the vinyl. And the more negatively charged the vinyl becomes, and the more positively charged the glass becomes. And now you see why vinyl is on the negative side of the triboelectric series, and glass is on the positive side of the triboelectric series. Rubbing vinyl with glass makes vinyl negative and glass positive. Humid air makes it harder to charge things up. Dry air is better. This is a relative humidity meter bought from a local hardware store. It's at 30 right now, and I was able to charge up the balloon and glass. But when it's at 80, things don't charge up as much. So if you're having problems, that may be the reason. Here are some other things to try. Rub your socks on carpet, and you'll often get a shock when you touch someone or a metal door handle. Run a plastic comb through your hair, or rub a plastic soda bottle against your hair. Some other examples are that a car sometimes gets charged, and you get a shock when you touch the door handle. And the non-metallic rollers and belt of a Van de Graaff generator are charged by triboelectricity. And, if you need to look up some materials, you can find a more complete triboelectric series table on my website here. There's also a link to it in this video's description. And lastly, why did the balloon stick to the wall? As I said, the part of the balloon that I rubbed against my hair became negatively charged. The wall, however, is neutral. Same number of positives as negatives. But like charges repel each other, so the negative charge of the balloon repels some of the negative charge on the wall, deeper into the wall, leaving a more positively charged surface. And unlike charges attract each other, so the negatively charged area of the balloon is attracted to the positively charged surface of the wall. Well, thanks for watching. See my YouTube channel, rimstar.org, for more informative videos like this. That includes one on how to make your own electroscope, another on how a Van de Graaff generator works, and for variety, one on using Nitinol wire, a shape memory alloy, to make an inchworm walk across a table. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, share with your social media, or leave a question or comment below. Bye for now.